mind. Well, I wouldn't even give up.
Captain Abraham! Haul them in! Get off the wind! Burn the men! Twist those gallants!
What news are they?
This Barjon works for the Royal African Company. Tell him what you told me.
I haven't seen the princess for 8 weeks or more. Meaning she may soon be back.
What else?
I thought this buck belonged to the other man who was asking about the princess this morning. So I told him that...
What other man?
Haughty sailor in plain rags. And a gent with a scar just here.
Where have they got to?
Staying just round the corner, they said.
I grow tired of chasing these fantasies of yours, Edward. As does the crew.
Hang in there, man. We're getting close.
Thank you.
You won't lose us that easily.
Not worth the effort.
Intruder!
Violence, the refuge of scoundrels.
Have you alerted the men? We're short on time.
Aye. There'll be two soldiers waiting for us at the crossroads.
Very good.
If you don't mind me asking, sir, what's the meaning behind these blood samples we're taking?
Torres tells me that blood is required for the observatory to properly function.
How do you mean, sir?
If one wishes to use the observatory to, say, spy on King George, then one would require a drop of the king's blood to do so. In other words, a small sample of blood gives us access to a man's everyday life.
Does Torres mean to spy on me then? For I've just given him a sample of my blood.
As have I, Captain Hornigold, as will all Templars. It is a measure of assurance.
And trust, I reckon.
Yes, but fear not. Torres has shipped our samples to a Templar safe house in Rio de Janeiro. We will not be the observatory's first subjects, I assure you.
Aye, sir. I suppose it's a small price to pay for what the Templars have given me in return.
Precisely.
Governor, when you hunted pirates in Madagascar, what methods worked best?
I believe it was my charisma that persuaded them. Violence and threats should always be a last resort. In Madagascar, I offered those pirates a choice. Take a pardon and return to England penniless but free men, or be hanged by the net and killed dead.
Just as you did in Nassau.
Precisely. A pity Commodore Chamberlain did not live to see my thorough success.
It's not like you to gloat, Rogers.
We all deserve a moment, don't we?
Thank you.
Grandmaster, welcome.
Buenas noches. What have you got?
The princess was taken by pirates 6 weeks ago. And so far as we know, the Sage Roberts was still aboard.
Very good. There's something.
Grandmaster. I should have sailed there myself. One of my slave galleys would be more than capable of making a strict journey.
Slave galley? Captain, I ask you to test yourself.
I fail to see the difference between enslaving some men and all men. Our aim is to steer the entire course of civilization, is it not?
A body enslaved inspires the mind to rebel.
Right.
Enslave a man's mind, and his body will follow. Natural.
A fair point, Grandmaster.
Remind me, where in Africa are we looking?
Principe, sir, a small island.
We've sent two of our best men, Burgess and Cochrane. Privateers with fast ships and firm hearts.
Edward Kenway! Imagine my surprise at seeing your jackdaw anchored there. Have you heard all you came to hear? Will you now rescue the sage from our clutching hands?
A pox on you, traitor! You sold us downriver.
Because I found a better path. The Templars know order, discipline, structure. But you never could fathom these subtleties. Goodbye, old friend. You were a soldier once, when you fought for something real. Something beyond yourself.
You're not getting through here.